Hi guys, today I would like to talk about Pelican cases and specifically what we can fit inside. The only one I have here is Pelican case 1400, and when I was buying it, it was really hard to visualize what actually can fit. You see this picture on the website, you know the dimension is like 11.8, 8.8, 5.18 inches. And you're like, can I fit my camera in? Can I fit lenses? Yeah, you don't like, yeah, you could theoretically you can measure everything. You can like, you know, create some sort of drawing and diagram and blah, blah, blah. But it's so much better to see what other people can fit in there, or to better to visualize what can be actually fit in there. The best thing is actually to go to the store and put your stuff in and Bob's your uncle, you understand if it fits or not, or you know, pick another 1450 for example if you need bigger and so on and so forth. But if you don't have opportunity to go to the store and actually try it out and you want to buy online, because sometimes online is actually cheaper, the better actually to have visualization. So in order to visualize what can compare sizes and what can fit inside this box, I printed 3D printed this 10 by 10 cube, or 10 by 10 by 10 or 100 millimeter cube. This is roughly a little bit less than 4 inches. So, okay, let's compare them first side by side. I think it's a little bit too bright, and the bright cube doesn't do good justice because it's kind of getting washed away. But here we are, kind of shelter it a bit from the light. So you can compare the cube, okay, and the case, right? So, okay, let's say this side, again, it's really hard to tell. Maybe white cube wasn't the best choice, should imprint it like in red or something, but I have what I have. Inside the black box, it'll be perfectly visible. So what? Okay, how we can visualize? So I can open the box or case and actually stuff the cube inside. So now we can see that theoretically we can put as maximum as, you know, two this way and one, two, and roughly two and a half this way. So this is already give us an opportunity to understand what kind of, you know, what kind of things can fit in the cube, inside the case. But this is still just the cube. It's still like, you know, you still have to compare it with some real life items. So for this purpose, I decided to try to stuff cameras in here. So for example, I have this DSLR. This is Canon 5D. And as you see, it perfectly fits. Lid closes, amazing. But we still have tons of space. Like for example, we have another, this is the lens, this is 200 millimeter Canon lens, still lots of space. This is some zoom lens I have lying around, 17 to 85 Canon lens. Again, we still have lots of space. And roughly another 100 cubic millimeters can fit in here, and so much more space. Mind you, I don't have any foam or padding. It really depends what you're going to be using with this. If you, for example, on the water canoeing, you won't be throwing this thing around. The main your concern is waterproofness. If you will be throwing this thing around or be traveling in some rough places, obviously it's better to have padding. It can be as thick as, you know, inch or two. Depends what you have, fragile or not fragile thing. Cameras actually pretty durable. This one was falling many, many times on the rocks and it's still perfectly working. But you're not anyone at risk. So roughly this is what can fit inside Pelican 1400 case. Obviously other cases would have a little bit different dimensions, but just to give you a reference point, an opportunity to understand what you can stuff in the case, I think this is a good exercise. This is the only case I have, so I cannot, you know, go and show you different other cases, but I hope this was a useful exercise and it help you to understand what can fit in those kind of Pelican cases. Or any other cases, because there are other manufacturers which produce similar waterproof, shockproof cases similar to Pelican. Well, guys, thank you for watching. I hope this video was useful. If you like it, please like and subscribe. Thank you. See you next time.